We have been watching every one of them since the day they were born. Those sweet little faces. Their clumsy antics. We love every one of them. They have keen hearing, yet they can put up with this noise level. Amazing! The busy highway outside Golden Hill Road is certainly not for me. A little bit better, but it should quieten down once I am in the grounds of Kam Shan Country Park, aka Monkey Hill. And it's now 10,000 times better. And what an exceptionally warm day today in the first week of February. Someone had a dip already. Another familiar face. That's Vince. A contemporary of Dopey, Naughty and Buddy. He really looks buff, doesn't he? Can't believe he was once that cute chubby boy of Nora's. He surely was the chubbiest baby I have ever seen on Monkey Hill. Can't believe what he has grown into. An equally buff male. A Mike Tyson of them all, born in 2016. But size isn't everything. He and Barry just aren't seen as family friendly. As far as I know, Vince was ousted about 3 years ago and he has been hanging around near this area to try to get accepted into Dane's troop. Finding a new home with another troop is the biggest hurdle for any male. And behold, there's another one who hasn't been successful either. Charlie, Lucy's son, born in 2017. He has been trying hard to get accepted into Nulla Troop, like Spocky has been doing. And like Spocky, he seems to have fallen out with Nulla Troop too. Thank you. He's back with a bunch of bachelors again. It seems Charlie may end up as a loner for life. He doesn't seem to be getting along with other bachelors either. Life turns out differently for each of the ousted boys from our gang, even in a small place like Monkey Hill. Seeing how our boys one day will be traipsing alone, faces bewildered and apprehensive, is a sight I dread. Hold on, I don't think that's one of Skullhead's. Definitely not. I recognize that one is from Annie's. Not sure about this one, though. And who are those over there? Loiners. How strange. What has happened to Skullhead's troop? What's happening? They are all scurrying away. Holy smoke! Our gang has turned up in force above. Incredible! Our gang has just chased Loina's troop into hiding. But it's not the whole story. It seems our gang is in turn being chased by Skullhead's troop. Now I wonder what was happening further up the road. Did some clueless feeder provoke Skullhead troop into action? Nope, so our gang hasn't been gallant. They were shitting their pants themselves. It seems the chaos is over. Skullhead troop has stopped their advance just over there. I wonder where our gang will be heading. It's a mishmash here. With kids from Annie's troop too. Skullhead's troop's sudden mobilization has thrown every troop in their way off course. And I have lost track of our gang too. Perhaps they might have gone to the usual hiding place? Let's go there, shall we? Oops. It seems Nora's troop has taken refuge here instead this time. Oh well. Now I haven't a clue where our gang could have gone. Oh well, I suppose let's not make waste of the goodies. How much I wish Bebe was among them lil' critters running around with her pouches filled to the brim too. Do her peers still remember her? I wonder. Okay. I think I have finished with Nora's troop. Back to the road. It's skull head everywhere. There's a dog inside that vehicle, I bet. Skullhead Troop will begin to line the road almost every day after 4 p.m. It is a habit they and many troops have picked up in the last 40 to 50 years. And it will be passed down to many generations to come for as long as there are 7 million people living in Hong Kong. You can see the kids in Skullhead Troop have been taught how to forage. They will never lose that skill living in the wild. I am not sure when the Brigade of Meals on Wheels will be here. But you can see they pin their trust on humans. This is a bond they have formed with humans over the last half a century. And it has helped to keep them in the mountains. Oh look! See who we have got here. our old boys are sticking together. Hooray! And there is Larry too. They are all hanging around near the periphery of Skullhead Troop. And seeing Larry is really a surprise to me. So he still got the boot in the end. Born in 2017, he really has overstayed his welcome. So are our old boys now members in Dopey's former boy band? Regardless, it's heartwarming to see them together, keeping an eye out for one another. The chance of them getting into Skullhead is higher if they are indeed in Dopey's former boy band. And it is all very clear now. Because there's Dopey. And his leg is so much better now. Yes, his acceptance of them should bode well for our old boys, one of whom is his little brother, or his junior from his natal troop. Who could have thought that Lil Runt, who had us all worried about, would one day become a saviour to all the subsequent Lil babies turned young adults to come? Thank you. Nitty will surely look out for his little brother, Cody. I think one of them is grooming him now. And that one is Tiddy. And let's not forget Buddy. Things are beginning to look up once again. For Dopey, and for those whom we have been worried about. And further up, Stumpy's only son is holding up too. And there is that new golden boy around too. And even that girl born handicapped with severe ectrodactyly. But this also means that Jubilee Troop is back again. At least for today. No wonder our gang was on the move earlier on. We have never given her a name. Shall we do so now? Dopey. As well as those boys from 2016. Will play an important role for those boys that have been ousted recently. Be their mentor and guide them. So that every one of them will find their wings in this new phase of their life. God forbid, none of them will ever get lost. Like we had with Batty, Mickey and half a dozen boys before them.